From a towering hilltop basilica to a stunning shrine nestled in the bluffs and a quiet chapel in the countryside, Wisconsin is home to three incredibly unique and reverent Marian shrines. Today on Discover Wisconsin, our travels take us on a spiritual journey unlike anything we've experienced before. In the Catholic Church, there's a strong devotion to Mary, the mother of Jesus, and a Marian shrine is a place built in her honor. In Wisconsin, there are three incredibly beautiful Marian shrines. Jake and I wanted to experience all three of these places in Wisconsin and hear the stories of those who have visited them. My first stop was Holy Hill National Shrine of Mary, Help of Christians, just outside of Milwaukee. This church is absolutely gorgeous. It's actually located on the highest point in southeastern Wisconsin. Arguably, what Holy Hill is best known for is its external beauty, but we got to take a look inside.
There was a cross that was placed on top of the hill in 1858. And so even before there was any building, people began to come to the place where the cross was. Shrines are always places where people make pilgrimage. A pilgrimage is a spiritual experience, a traveling from one place to another that kind of marks a way of looking to answer questions in one's life.
I think what is special about shrines is it does draw people, it seems to, of different backgrounds and different faiths. What is it about these shrines, and maybe about Holy Hill specifically, that you think is so fascinating and intriguing to other people?
It's a place of invitation. And so there's a beautiful hospitality that is really part of what a shrine is, because it doesn't matter ultimately where you're coming from. In a world that's just so busy, to be able to be in a place that's quiet and still, it's healing. Here at Holy Hill, at least since 1906, there's been a religious community of priests and brothers. Carmelite friars were invited from Bavaria to minister especially to the German immigrants here in this area. And we have our own community life together, where we eat together, we pray together, we recreate together as we serve the pilgrims who come to the shrine.
Holy Hill to me felt almost otherworldly. You feel like you're in, you know, this ancient place that is sacred. While our crew was there, we got to climb to the very top of the steeple to get a view of southeastern Wisconsin. The staircase starts to open up and you're seeing out to the Kettle Moraine. Hill is one of the most photographed places in the entire state of Wisconsin.
I continue the trip to the shrine of Our Lady of Guadalupe in La Crosse. Now, what really struck me when I got there was, boy, just the true beauty of the whole area, and not just the building itself. The shrine is absolutely gorgeous, but the grounds too. There's over 100 acres that people can walk around and really take time to reflect and pray.
This is such a beautiful place. I mean, that's what strikes me when I first come up here. And I mean, that's a big part of what brings people here too, isn't it?
Yes, the idea of a pilgrimage to a holy place. The holy place is not only supernaturally attractive, in other words, the pilgrims come to encounter God, but if there's also a natural attractiveness to draw them, the two things work together, and here they work together almost perfectly. We've tried to bring elements from the great history of Christian art and architecture. The altar in the church is modeled on the altar of the Basilica of St. Mary Major in Rome. There's a certain southwestern style in the architecture too, to connect us with the origin of the miracle in Mexico and so forth. So we've tried to really that the shrine be a place where people would experience the truth that the faith is universal, it's one throughout the whole world, that they have new hope for their lives and that they know deeply God's love for them.
The feast day of Our Lady of Guadalupe is celebrated every year on December 12th, and it's meant to honor the apparition of Mary to St. Juan Diego in Mexico in 1531.
I Every year there are many who come for the feast day. It's the biggest feast of the year for the church, and there are many special traditions attached to this feast day, especially among the Mexicans. They bring with them this love and devotion towards the Mother of Christ under the title of Our Lady of Guadalupe. And with that devotion and love towards her, you know, the various traditions that have been handed down over generations, the celebration of Las Mañanitas, very special traditional Mexican songs in her honor. And then usually it's followed by the celebration of Holy Mass, and then the traditional pan dulce, sweetbreads that they serve.
This is our tradition for Mexico, so we like to do it here because we live here. We got a beautiful shrine, we got a beautiful church, and very good people around here too.
Going back to those traditions from your roots are essential and heartwarming, and finding that here, it's a blessing to have this place here in La Crosse.
Tens of thousands of people make a pilgrimage to this shrine every single year, and really they come for a variety of reasons.
We're here at the shrine with my wife in honor of her brother who has prostate cancer. When he made his trip here, I believe he felt that it helped. And because his numbers are going way down now, and it's very positive for all of us.
If this is a slice of heaven, it's like heaven's door right here in Wisconsin.
Our Lady is always, always answering prayers and performing miracles here.
We came all the way from Arizona. It's a nice retreat to get away from the craziness of the world.
Our Lady of Good Help is the smallest of the three shrines, but it's an incredibly important place. It's where the Virgin Mary appeared to Adele Bryce in 1859, and it's actually the only Marian apparition that's approved in the United States by the Catholic Church.
The Blessed Mother asked Adele to gather the children in this wild country and teach them what they needed to know for salvation. Adele then took that on. Every day she would walk to the different farmsteads, and Adele would teach them just basics, the sign of the cross, some basic prayers. She's such a simple woman. I think that's probably what really resonates for many people today. This is a very simple shrine, a simple place to come and pray. And really that's what Adele recognized, and that's what she respected.
The biggest event at the shrine is the Solemnity of the Assumption of the Virgin Mary. And you've got hundreds of people that attend this outdoor mass that really is all about honoring Mary heading into heaven. After the Catholic Church formally approved the apparition in 2010, the Bishops' Conference of the United States designated Our Lady of Good Help as a national shrine in 2016.
Now that it's a national shrine, you would think that this would bring even more recognition to that and more pilgrims to come to this place.
Well, you know, people receive very personal blessings here. Some of them receive healings even. They come here and they center on peace. And that's a beautiful gift for all of us today.
There are so many reported instances of miracles and healings that occur at this shrine. In fact, one of the most well-known miraculous events that took place here is called the Miracle of Fire.
In 1871, the Peshtigo Fire was raging in this area, and people knew this place to be a place of refuge to Our Blessed Mother. They came here and they prayed. The fire came and burned all around them, but this 5-acre land was preserved and protected by Our Blessed Lady. That was actually written in the history books. Everything around was a sea of ash, and this shone like an emerald in that ash, that everything was destroyed, and this 5 acres property was perfectly preserved.
When I heard this story, I mean, I got chills just hearing it and thinking about it. Every October, on the anniversary of the fire, pilgrims come and listen to a historical reading of that night, and then they walk around the perimeter of the chapel praying the rosary, just like the people who came here for protection did back in 1871.
This place has always been a great place of faith for many people, and so the miracle of the Peshtigo fire really represents that faith, that favor that God granted to them, and it's been passed down through generations of families and people who have always put that great trust in Our Blessed Mother.
You know, after visiting these Marian shrines, I can tell you the thing that strikes me, just thinking about it, is just the true beauty of so many of these places and just the passion that's involved in the people that go there to pray or to heal.
If you're not religious at all, if you practice a different religion other than Catholicism, I think that's all the more reason to experience each one of these shrines. one of the most important things you can do in life is just experience things that you don't know about or things that are unfamiliar to you, because I got the opportunity to learn about all of these people and the lives that they lead that may seem very different from mine, but I also got to learn a lot about myself in the process. I think what filming this episode taught me was, you know, everyone has questions about life and about their faith. We're all looking for answers, and that is what a pilgrimage is all about, and that is what these shrines exist for. I think that's a pretty amazing thing to take advantage of.
Hello, I'm Father James Kubicki, and today is the anniversary of the Great Chicago Fire of 1871. It burned up whole parts of the city and killed an estimated 300 people. But what many people don't know is that a worse fire in Peshtigo, northern Wisconsin, burned over 1 million acres, twice the size of the state of Rhode Island. Estimates of those who were killed by it range from 1,500 to 2,500. The fire was so intense that it jumped across part of Lake Michigan, Green Bay, and spread into Door County. When the fire drew near to a chapel in what is now Champion, Wisconsin, a woman named Adele refused to leave and instead organized a procession around the perimeter of the grounds where other people had gathered to pray as the fire approached, and they expected to die in it. But the fire stopped. When light dawned the next morning, the people saw black and charred fields all around and a haven of green where they had safely spent the night. Today, this place is known as the Shrine of Our Lady of Good Help and is the first approved Marian apparition in the United States. You see, 12 years earlier, the Blessed Mother appeared there to Adele, who was 16 at the time. She asked her parish priest what to do, and he told her to ask the apparition, "In the name of God, who are you? "And what do you wish of me?" Adele asked the mysterious lady the third time she appeared, and the lady said, "I am the Queen of Heaven, who prays for the conversion of sinners, and I wish you to do the same." That was in October 1859. Won't you join Mary this month and every month to pray the rosary as she has requested so often for the conversion of sinners?
All right, ready? 1, 2, 3. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed all the fish boil talk. Enjoy your meal tonight.
Stick the blankets back.
Welcome to Holy Redeemer Church. Holy Redeemer is one of the churches of the Cathedral Parish in downtown Madison, Wisconsin. It is loved by many for the traditional beauty of its interior, little changed since the early 20th century. In 1857, Bishop Henney of Milwaukee established Holy Redeemer, the second Catholic parish in the city, as the home for the German-speaking Catholics in Madison. And Holy Redeemer is also the site of one of the two perpetual Eucharistic adoration chapels in the Diocese of Madison. The three altars in the sanctuary were installed in 1901. In the late 1960s, to accommodate the liturgical changes of the Second Vatican Council, the altar of sacrifice was cut away from the reredos and moved forward. In this way, the visual integrity of the high altar was maintained. The altar of sacrifice is adorned with a bas-relief showing the Last Supper, at which the Lord instituted the Eucharist. In the reredos behind the altar is a depiction of the crucifixion, the sacrifice which is made present in the offering of the Mass. Immediately beneath the crucifix is the tabernacle, where we find the Blessed Sacrament, the hosts previously consecrated at Mass, which have become the true body of Christ. The crucifixion group in the center of the reredos depicts the Blessed Virgin Mary and Saint John standing beneath the cross of Christ. Notice the paleness of the dead body of the Lord Jesus in contrast to the healthier complexions of Mary and John. Above Christ crucified, God the Son, can be found the representation of God the Father and God the Holy Spirit, appearing as at the baptism of the Lord in the form of a dove.
We were born to chase your dreams. Come, my Lord, awaken holy fire. We are turning from our sin. We are praying once again. Come, my Lord, awaken holy fire.
Lord. star, light a fire in our hearts. Burn like a star, light a fire in our hearts. Burn like a star, light a fire in our hearts. Burn like a star, light a fire in our hearts. Burn like a star, light a fire in our hearts. Burn like a star, light a fire in our
Today we are at St. Cecilia's Catholic Church in Wisconsin Dells, Wisconsin. This church has a long history in this community, well over 100 years, which is long for this part of the world. It's been in this same location, not for its entire history, but for most of it, and has been a constant bedrock in this community. Music is important for this church because the church teaches us that singing is a sign of the heart's joy, and music helps people to sing.
Music is very important to the parish because our name of the parish, St. Cecilia, St. Cecilia is the patron saint of music.
The organ is the singular most important investment in our music ministry.
As to establish a new level of music at St. Cecilia's and raise it to something very special, because worship and mass brings you the closest to heaven as we can here on earth. New organ is a Johannes Monarch. It is a 3-manual custom designed and with digitally recorded high quality pipe sounds from organs in France. So many parishioners will come up after Mass and ask where the pipes are.